What's up guys, welcome to my channel. Today we will experience the actual beam power. I am going to design a structural column. I am going to model actual rebars and then I am going to prepare the rebar schedule. So stay with me, and if you want to learn, watch the full video. But first make sure to subscribe to my channel. So here I am in Revit and I am going to start with a structural template. So we have level 1 and level 2 in structural plans. I am going to structure tab and click on column. In properties panel, I will select a column and then set it to height and level 2. Height means we are starting from level 1 and going up to level 2. I am going to place the column anywhere on the drawing and then hit escape key a couple of times. Again, I will go to structure tab and this time select isolated footing. In the properties panel, I will select a footing. I will hover over the column and you can see it snaps to the center line of column. I am going to click on the center of column and place my footing. Now I will open the south elevation and you can see the column with footing is ready. Then I am going to view tab and click on tile window button, which will organize both views on one screen. Our model is ready to place the rebars. I am going to structure tab, reinforcement panel and click on rebar. Click OK on dialog box and you can see the rebar shape browser on the right side of screen. Now I will find stirrups. Hover over the column and you can see the stirrups. Make sure select the far cover reference and parallel to work plane. I will change the diameter of bar because we usually use thinner bars for stirrups. Now I will click on the column and our stirrup is in place. I am going to place the vertical rebars. Again go to rebars and this time find the straight rebar shape. This time I will select the perpendicular to the cover. I am going to use thicker bar for the verticals. Now hover over the column and it automatically snaps to stirrup bar. I am going to place single rebar on all four corners. Now go to south elevation and you can see our stirrup bar is only a single rebar. I will select this rebar and in rebar set, I will set the layout to maximum spacing and then input the maximum spacing values. Also, our vertical rebars doesn't extend inside the footing. In order to extend the rebars, select all vertical rebars. We can also use filter options to select rebars. Then I am going to properties panel, dimension section and change the values and then apply. Now this extension looks fine. It's time to place the rebars in footing. I am going to go to rebar section and I will select U-shape rebars for footing. Then in south elevation, if I hover over the footing and you can see it snaps to the corner boundaries. I am going to change the diameter of bar and I will place a rebar perpendicular to work plane and a rebar parallel to work plane. If I go to level 1 plan, you can see two rebars. I'm going to select them one by one and then change the layout tool to maximum spacing. And change the spacing values for both side rebars. If you see in south elevation, both rebars intersect on same plane, which is not possible. So I am going to select and grab from arrows and place one just above the other. I am going to do the same for vertical portions at the end and modify them in level 1 plan. I will grab them from the arrow grips and move them a bit toward the column. We have completed the rebars in column and footing. Now I am going to open the 3D view and change the visual styles to wireframe. I want to view the actually modeled rebars in 3D view. So I am going to select the column and footing. Then I am going to open the filter and uncheck the column and footing and leave the rebars. And then apply and OK. I am going to properties panel and edit the view visibility states. In the dialog box, check mark the view unobscured and view as solid and then click OK. Now set the visual styles to realistic and you can see the nice gray colored rebars modeled in 3D view. In order to recognize the rebars in schedule, we need to assign schedule marks. So I am going to assign new schedule marks to my rebars. I am going to select the footing rebar and go to Properties panel, Construction section and write F1 for this. Then I will select the other rebar and assign F2. Then I will select the column stirrups and assign ST for stirrups. Then select the vertical bars and assign V for vertical. Next, I am going to open the 3D view and zoom on top of the column and extend the rebars in order to make the staggered splice or coupler joint. We are all set to prepare the rebar schedule. I am going to View tab, Create panel and open the schedules. In New Schedule dialog, I am going to find the structural rebars. I am going to rename this schedule as column with footing rebar schedule and then click OK. In the schedule properties box, I am going to select the required fields. So we need schedule mark, we need bar diameter, rebar length. We need sizes of rebars for which I am going to select A, B, C, D and E. After that we need quantities or count of rebars and also we need total rebar length. And finally, I am going to place images. I have selected all necessary fields to make a schedule. Then finally, I will click OK. You can see Revit automatically prepares a complete rebar schedule, which includes all details which we need. But one thing we don't have in this schedule is the images of rebar shapes, which is far most important thing in schedules, especially when you prepare it for the workshop where people actually fabricate the rebars. To add the shapes, I just click on empty cell, and in the manage shapes dialog box I will click add. I have some shapes saved in my PC, so I am going to import them into this project. And here we have the shapes. Now I am going to assign these rebars one by one to my schedule cells. Now I want to remove the millimeter sign from all of the cells. As we know, our basic unit is mm. So I will open the project units, and here I will go to structural units and then click on reinforcement length. In the format box, I am going to change the symbol to none. If I open the schedules again, you can see we no longer have millimeter signs with all dimensions. Next, I will align the text in my schedule table and then resize the columns for a better look. Next, I will go in the project browser and create a new sheet. I want to import the A3 matrix sheet into my project, so I will click on load button, and then in my libraries I will go to matrix folder and find the title block and then A3 sheet file and click open. It is very simple to place a rebar schedule in the sheet. I am just going to drag the schedule from the project browser and place it in the sheet. You can see the image section is very small, so I extend the image column. Next, I will open the south elevation and I am going to set the view scale to 1:25. I am going to shorten the level datum lines and place them near the column drawing. Now I am going to open the sheet and then drag the south elevation into the sheet. Later on, we can change the view scales in the south elevation and adjust the drawing in the sheet. And that's all. Our rebar schedule and drawing set in the sheet is ready to send for the fabrication workshop. If you enjoyed this video, please like the video and give your valued suggestions in comment section. And then share this video. But please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching this video. See you in the next one.